Condoleezza Rice has written a hard-hitting new book about her 8 years in the Bush administration. It's called No Higher Honor, a memoir of my years in Washington. And in it, the former National Security Advisor and Secretary of State does not hold back, painting a detailed and often disturbing portrait of policymaking during a time of war. But I began when I sat down with her by asking a question she doesn't directly address in her memoir. Was the long and costly war in Iraq worth the sacrifice?
Every international relations class starts with the Middle East is the most volatile region in the world. We also now know that it was the cradle of Al-Qaeda and extremism, and therefore
it was... Al-Qaeda wasn't in Iraq.
No,
you know that,
but,
yeah.
But Al-Qaeda, well, Osama bin Laden was a Saudi. The Zawahiri was an Egyptian. This came out of the Middle East. Now, we didn't go to Iraq to bring democracy to the Iraqis, and I try in the book to really explain that that wasn't the purpose.
Some in the administration thought it was.
Well, but we were very clear about this. This was a security threat, and I, as much as anybody, understand and really regret the cost, particularly in lives. But I also know that nothing of value is ever won without sacrifice.
Couldn't have happened at a lower cost?
I don't know how. I don't think that Saddam was removable by any other means.
Rice has been the target of fellow Bush administration officials critical of her performance during the war, including Defense Secretary Don Rumsfeld.
She'd never served in a senior administration position. She'd been an academic, and, you know, a lot of academics like to have meetings.
In her book, she fires back.
The Defense Department didn't execute at critical times.
At one point, after several clashes, she even confronted Rumsfeld outside the Oval Office.
I said to him, you know, I don't know what's gone wrong between us. And he said he didn't either. And then he said something about my being bright. And it's
something about that word.
Yeah, it just bugged me. It was one of those words that you don't use about a colleague.
Condescending?
I use it about my students sometimes. Not condescending, just a term of inequality.
Then there was Vice President Dick Cheney. Dismissive of her in his book, he also said that Rice tearfully admitted he was right after a disagreement over whether to apologize for those 16 words on Iraq's WMD in the Bush State of the Union.
Did you go to him with tears in your eyes?
Not that I remember. It's sort of not like me. I did tell him that he was right, that the press would react in a particular way to admitting that the 16 words should not have been in the president's speech. But tearful, no.
It seems like Vice President Cheney came away from this with less respect for you. He's asked if you were a competent Secretary of State. His answer is,
in some regards.
He clearly did not like the turn of policy after I became Secretary of State. That's very clear. But I never felt that it was personal. I still have high respect and high regard for him.
You also write that it created a cycle of distrust and dysfunction. Didn't all this dysfunction add to the price we paid in Iraq?
We could have done better. And you're right. As I've looked back on this, I think, well, if it had been a more smoothly functioning team, might we have gotten some of these issues out under the table and resolved. But you also have to remember that this was a big proposition, Iraq.
Her description of security scares inside the White House read like they came straight out of a thriller, like October 2001. The president has just arrived in Shanghai.
The vice president came on the screen and said that the White House detectors had detected botulinum toxin, and we were all, those of us who were exposed, were going to die.
He said that?
Yes, he said that. And I remember everybody just sort of freezing and the president saying, what was that? What was that, Dick?
Including the president?
Including the president, because the exposure time would have meant that we were all exposed.
Rice's deputy said they'd run tests, but that would take 24 hours.
He said, let me put it this way, if the mice are feet up, we're toast. If the mice are feet down, we're fine.
But wait a second, for 24 hours we didn't know if the president had been poisoned?
For 24 hours I got to him on the phone, he said the mice are feet down. I went back to the president and I said, the mice are feet down. And the president said, that's a good thing. And I'm sure the Chinese, who probably got a translation, thought it was some sort of code.
Perhaps nothing was more surreal than her encounter with the late Libyan dictator Muammar Gaddafi. He was fixated on her, bringing Rice inside his private kitchen to show her a personal video.
It It was actually just a bunch of pictures of me. He said, and I had Libya's best composer, most famous composer, write this song for you, and it was called Black Flower in the White House. And I thought, well, this is a really, really strange moment in my time as Secretary of State, and I ate quickly and got on the plane for Algeria.
What do you think he wanted from you?
I think Gaddafi lived inside his own head. I don't think he really wanted anything.
Fascinating behind-the-scenes stuff there from the former Secretary of State. I'll have more of my interview tonight on Nightline.